engineers have made a practical success of an engine at first thought to be unsuitable for motor and aircraft use. This is the compression ignition or oil engine. The petrol engine is limited to quite low compression ratios by the tendency of the petrol to pink or detonate. In the oil engine, such detonation does not occur. So higher compression ratios, giving greater efficiency, can be used. In the oil engine, air alone is drawn into the cylinder. It is then highly compressed. Its temperature rises so much that the fuel is ignited spontaneously when injected directly into the cylinder. Thus, like the petrol engine, the compression ignition engine has a four-stroke cycle. Air drawn in, air compressed, fuel injected and ignited, exhaust. To get the best results, the fuel must be mixed very efficiently with the air. So the air is often made to swirl round in a chamber called the combustion chamber, apart from the cylinder. Combustion will then be rapid and complete. Ignition, exhaust, induction, compression. In this engine, rockers moved by cams on an overhead camshaft work the valves. This train of gears drives both the camshaft for the valves and the cams which work the pumps. These force the fuel through the injectors into the cylinders. There is one fuel pump to each cylinder. Each pump not only forces fuel through the injector, but meters the quantity at the same time. The injectors turn the fuel into a very fine spray. Combustion pressures in an oil engine are high. This means that the engine must be strongly built. Weight and cost are increased. The oil engine tends to run more roughly than the petrol engine. Nevertheless, in certain applications, the more efficient use of the fuel it burns gives the oil engine an economic advantage over the petrol engine.